Well, last week, the Justice Department launched an investigation into the controversial live interview conducted by SMNI News with convicted felon Jovito Palparan. That interview of a convicted kidnapper was widely criticized. Among those who slammed the incident, detained Senator Leila de Lima. Joining us now is Senator de Lima's legal counsel and spokesperson, Attorney Dino De Leon. Attorney De Leon, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Welcome to the program. First off, I want to get the senator's reaction to what was discussed in last night's debate. Leody de Guzman saying she simply should be freed, while the others said due process must be followed. What is the senator's take on this?
Well, the senator is happy that at least Leody recognized her plight, the fact that she is persecuted. She is constantly being attacked, and despite her innocence. So Senator Leila de Lima extends her thanks as well to those people who recognize that, in fact, she has to be given due process. You know, Carmina, if Senator Leila de Lima has been given due process, this shouldn't have reached this far. She has been incarcerated for the last 5 years. At least 7 judges have recused themselves from the proceedings. It's just too long for somebody to be unjustly incarcerated, especially if that particular person is innocent. In fact, let's remember that the United Nations Working Group on Arbitrary Detention has already stated categorically that after due investigation, what they saw was Senator Leila de Lima was arbitrarily incarcerated, ikinulong arbitrarily, just because she was doing her job as a senator.
You mentioned about continued attacks against the senator, and one such thing again happened during an SMNI interview with convicted felon Jovito Palparan. Let me ask you first, Attorney De Leon, should the interview have happened to begin with?
Well, we are quite surprised because we've had so many motions already on the part of Senator Leila de Lima, especially considering the fact that all of us have the right to be informed of the platform of candidates. But such was repeatedly denied by the court, even though Senator Leila de Lima is not convicted felon. However, in the case of Jovito Palparan, he is convicted. He was sentenced to reclusion perpetua, 20 to 40 years in prison, and yet his interview was heavily subsidized by the state, no less than by Undersecretary Badoy. So why is it that Undersecretary Badoy and NPFL are so busy red-tagging the campaign of Vice President Teddy Robredo and everyone in the state, including Senator Leila de Lima? For us, perhaps it's a bit of a good news because they're so busy attacking VP Leila Robredo, because we know for a fact that her campaign is gaining traction, and then all of a sudden, they're now attacking Senator Leila de Lima, and because we know for a fact that her campaign is gaining traction too.
The interview happened, and as you mentioned a while ago, a lot of people raised their eyebrows and really questioned why it happened in the first place. What do you think about how it upholds the fact that this interview happened, how it upholds or even undermines the rights of PDLs and detainees on both ends, attorney?
Well, to begin with, we have to understand the philosophy behind the criminal justice system. The reason why convicted criminals are actually in jail is because they have to be isolated from the rest of society, precisely because of all their moral misgivings and the crimes that they have committed. And then all of a sudden, we will see convicted felons taking the airwaves of the nation, and it is being subsidized by the state and being enabled by a government task force. So it's a bit bothering that what we are allowing such kinds of things from happening, which is very much against the very philosophy of our criminal justice system. Make no mistake, it is very clear that the claims being peddled by Badoy and Palparan in that interview are fairy tales. And in fact, Badoy and Palparan have zero credibility. As we know, the huge difference between Palparan and Senator Leila de Lima is that Palparan is convicted of a crime involving moral turpitude in 2018. In other words, he's still trying to blame Senator Leila de Lima for the fact of his conviction, but it was the Duterte administration who continued the prosecution, and he was convicted in 2018. So the circumstances are a little bit suspicious. The fact that it was the government of Duterte who actually prosecuted him, secured a conviction, and then right now they are blaming Leila de Lima. You know, this is very reminiscent of their ploy back in 2016 when they also tried to incarcerate Senator Leila de Lima peddled the false charges against her because they also use convicted felons. So the circumstances are suspect. This has been seen by the Filipino people before, and maybe the only difference is lumang tugtugin na yan, para bang lagi natin sinasabi, style bulok. Mm. Kasi ginawa na nga nila before, and then that's the same kind of style that they're doing right now using convicted criminals against Senator.
Attorney De Leon, the family and relatives of Karen Empeño and Sherilyn Kadapan, they call this a travesty of justice. How does the senator describe what just happened? What does she call this?
Definitely, it's a gross case of injustice. It's a gross disrespect towards the victims of General Jovito Palparan and all the other individuals who suffered from his cruel hands, as categorically found by the Supreme Court. It's also it also reeks of desperation on the part of Badoy, who's precisely because a lot of cases are already piling up against her, and her sins are catching up on her, which is why she's so desperate right now. It's in the case of Palparan, it also reeks of desperation because he is also a convicted felon, and of course he's rotting in jail. So perhaps he's trying his best to actually secure the good graces of this administration to be able to strike a deal before Duterte goes down from office. So,
but it's not just Under Secretary Lorraine Badoy, Attorney Dino. There's also Bucor Director General Gerald Bantag, who justified the interview because they wanted to air the expertise of Jovito Palparan. What does that tell you? And what should that tell the public?
There are so many experts on national security. Why is it that they have to bend the principles of our justice system? Why is it that they did not secure the approval of any competent court? And in this particular case, you know, does that mean that every time that there is a perceived expertise of a convicted felon, we will lend them there are airwaves, and that will be subsidized to the state? Of course, ito ay palusot. Palusot lamang. Kasi sinusubukan nila mag-orchestrate again on something na ginawa na nila ng 2016. Pero it looks like they are failing. So these are all acts of desperation. It is an attack towards our justice system. And malalang-malala na yung mga biktima man lang ng mga violent crimes ni Vito Palparan ay hindi nila inisip kung anong marami.
Attorney De Leon, the DOJ has already instructed Undersecretary Deo Marco to investigate. We did reach out to him before our airing today to ask him about the latest in the investigation, and he did say that they are waiting for the report. But to you, as you saw things happen, what are the glaring violations here?
What sa akin, syempre lagi ako sinasabi, let's give due process. And tama naman na mag-investiga sila, no? But the facts are very clear. What else has to be investigated upon? It is very clear that the Bureau of Corrections allowed this to happen. It is very clear that the interview is subsidized by the state. It is very clear that Jovito Palparan is convicted of a crime involving moral turpitude and has been sentenced to reclusion, to suffer the penalty of reclusion perpetua. So what else has to be investigated upon? Ang kailangan dito ay parusahan na yung kailangan managot, kasi binayolate nila ang fundamental principles ng ating justice system, ng ating correctional system, and they are allowing a convicted felon to promulgate lies on national TV.
And this so, despite that there is a pending appeal before the Court of Appeal. So he was...
Yes, it doesn't cancel out the fact that he is a convicted felon. He is a convicted felon. There's already a conviction by a competent trial court, no? So malinaw na malinaw yung ebidensya doon. He was given a day in court, no? And he was allowed to actually offer all pieces of evidence to his defense. But regardless, the prosecution was able to secure a conviction. That means that they were able to show beyond reasonable doubt, beyond moral certainty, that indeed he is convicted of all the atrocities being accused of him. So why is it right now that all of a sudden he is being treated as a regular citizen?
As you mentioned, and then, I'm sorry to cut you there, Attorney De Leon, because we're running out of time and we do have a couple of more questions to get in edgewise. Now, this interview happened upon the insistence of the NTF-LCAC. Should Senator Leila de Lima win, what is her plan regarding the agency? Is she going to move to abolish? Is she going to move to defund the agency?
Evidently, Senator Leila de Lima would want to reassess the priorities of the NPFL. Senator Leila de Lima agrees that there has to be a whole of government approach in terms of ending the armed struggle. But that means that it is not through red tagging, it is not through violations of human rights, but rather Senator Leila de Lima fully understands why there is an armed struggle. It's precisely because a lot of our sectors of our society are being oppressed. Nakakalimutan sila, kaya nga sila nasa laylayan. And that's the reason why napitritan silang mamundok. So for Senator Leila de Lima, she will continue the whole of government approach, but she will in no way tolerate abuses against human rights and red tagging, especially considering that she used to be the chairperson of the Commission on Human Rights. So no yan, red line yan, and she will reassess. And if she finds out that the NPF will still constantly violate fundamental human rights, she will lead the charge in making sure that they are held into account.
What does the senator make of the flip-flopping of Vice President Lenny Robredo regarding the issue? First, she said she was going to abolish the NTF-LCAC, and then later on clarified that to saying that she believes in the mandate and will pursue this, as you said, whole-of-nation approach. But people already at that time called her a flip-flopper. How does the senator justify that?
Senator Leila de Lima doesn't see it as a flip-flop, precisely because Vice President Lenny Robredo was very clear. She believes in the mandate, but it seems like the agency itself right now is structured in such a way that will not achieve its mandate. So perhaps it's time to abolish the NTF-LCAC and build something that is stronger, that has a whole of government approach, but will not be created in such a way that it appears like the priority is red tagging of activists, of civil society leaders, of student leaders. No, that's the wrong approach. In fact, what's happening is it will be counterproductive instead of solving the problem of armed struggle, because people feel like they're again being pushed to the edge, so that they have no other recourse but to go to the boondocks.
Finally,
so it's not a flip flop. That's the status of the LED.
Finally, Attorney De Leon, let's go back to the Palparan interview. The senator, in a recent statement, also said that this may just be a prelude to a presidential pardon. How so? And how much of a possibility is this as we speak?
That is exactly the thought of the cap of Senator Leila de Lima and Senator Leila de Lima herself. Because we've seen this happen in the past. You know, they made a lot of deals when they asked convicted felons to testify against Senator Leila de Lima. In fact, one of the witnesses in the cases categorically stated that he is a drug lord, but he is not, no charges are being pressed by the Duterte administration. There seems to be a deal. So the question then becomes, why is it that all of a sudden their Palparan is being used by this administration, reminiscent of what they did in the past? What is the deal behind this? And what anong pinangahawakan ni Jovito Palparan at bakit siya biglang lumalabas? At sinisisi na naman si Senator Leila de Lima, kahit ang nag-convict sa kanya in 2018 is the Duterte administration. Mukha yata na merong silang pinangahawakan kay Jovito Palparan. Either it's a carrot or it's a stick. Is his safety at stake? We don't know exactly the motivations behind the actions of General Palparan. But what is clear is these are all fairy tales. These are all lies. And the chain of events appears to be clear. He was convicted in 2018. Senator Leila de Lima was already incarcerated during that point.
We're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Dino De Leon, Senator Leila de Lima spokesperson and legal counsel, we appreciate you taking our call today. Thank you. Take care. Keep safe.
Thank you, Carmina, and to all our viewers.